lucky to be yours. Bonjour à tous. Hello everybody. Welcome to my channel. I'm glad you are here. On our recent trip, we stayed a few nights at different hotels in Las Vegas. It's true that it's not so relaxing when you have to check in, unpack, pack, check out, and go to a different hotel to start all over. But there are so many hotels in Vegas, and I actually try to stay in more than one hotel each time I go to Las Vegas. Don't be surprised. There are nearly 300 hotels and resorts, which comes to more than 151,000 rooms in total. I'll show you three different charming hotels and their rooms in my next videos. If you want to have a staycation and only stay at the hotel including your room, pool, and one of the hotel bars or restaurants, I agree that it might be worth staying at a super luxurious hotel. On the other hand, if you're planning to go out to explore Las Vegas most of the day, honestly, I think a regular room at a hotel with an original theme would be more than sufficient. But again, I also understand that everybody has his or her own expectation for a hotel and a hotel room. Today, I will show you Golden Nugget or the Golden Nugget Las Vegas. If you wonder what the hotel looks like, please come with us to check it out. Let's go! Allons-y! Hotels in Las Vegas are concentrated in two main areas of Las Vegas, downtown and Strip. Today, we stay at Golden Nugget in downtown Las Vegas. The Golden Nugget Las Vegas is a hotel and casino located in downtown Las Vegas on the Fremont Street Experience. So, everything about downtown Las Vegas attractions are in close proximity. The hotel has multiple entrances, one of which is directly from the Fremont Street Experience. If you like the Fremont Street Experience, you're right bang on with it at the Golden Nugget. The Golden Nugget was originally built in 1946, making it one of the oldest casinos in Las Vegas. The hotel's original theme is Gold Rush, and the interior and exterior of the hotel demonstrates this theme quite well. The Golden Nugget was acquired by the current owner Landry's in 2005. There is a huge area of a casino on the main floor like most Las Vegas hotels. I'd like to let you know, just in case you haven't known it yet, that the casino areas of the majority of the Las Vegas hotels allow smoking. All hotel hallways are non-smoking, as are restaurants and several other areas of the hotels, but smoking is allowed on the casino floor in Las Vegas in general. We arrive at the hotel just before 2 p.m., and there is an option of early check-in that will cost $30, or an upgrade for $40 per night that includes an early check-in. So, we pay for an upgrade to a premier California King room that has 439 square feet of living space. Our room is located at Rush Tower that houses 500 renovated rooms. Rush Tower is the most recent addition to the resort, completed in 2009. The hotel has 2,419 rooms in total. The hotel is built around two aquariums. The larger aquarium is called a tank, which contains 200,000 gallons or 757 liters of water. The smaller aquarium is in the lobby of the Rush Tower by the seafood restaurant Charter House, and it contains 75,000 gallons or 284,000 liters of water. Most fish in the tank are inedible tropical fish. The larger aquarium faces the swimming pool and incorporates a slide through the tank containing full-grown sharks. Please be reminded that our room is slightly upgraded from a regular room. The room is spacious and faces the Las Vegas Strip at a distance. It's quite nice, isn't it? I really like that there is a comfortable bathroom and a separate lavatory. You know, these days hotel rooms have most toiletries on the wall. At least, Golden Nugget offers two body lotion. The room is equipped with a 55-inch LED HD TV. The room has plenty of drawers to unpack and organize things. Lighting in the room is quite good. Oh, I actually don't like hotel rooms to be too bright, so the lighting is good by my standards. This room has a mini fridge where you can keep your drinks or food cold, if needed. One thing really nice about this hotel room is that they provide a few bottles of water to make sure that you are well hydrated. The only issue for me is that the mattress of the bed is kind of plush. Well, I'm a super firm mattress person. If you like a plush mattress, you'd like it. I really like the lounge sofa in the room, from which I can enjoy the view outside. It is placed at a perfect place to look outside from the most comfortable position. Overall, it's quite a nice hotel. Everything is in-house, including a casino, two connected pools, and 10 restaurants, including two steakhouses, Vic & Anthony's and Saltgrass Steakhouse. Vic & Anthony's is more formal, and Saltgrass Steakhouse is more casual. The other restaurants and bars in the hotel are composed of an Italian, Asian, and Mexican restaurants and two casual dining places, as well as a Starbucks and a Chick-fil-A. Servers are really nice and you can have a drink without ordering food during the day. I quite enjoy observing the surroundings while sipping my beer. You see, you don't even need to go outside if you don't want to. But if you step out of the hotel, the Freeman Street experience starts right there. The Freeman Street Experience, or FSE in short, is a pedestrian mall and attraction in downtown Las Vegas. The FSE occupies the westernmost 5 blocks of Fremont Street. The central attraction is a barrel vault canopy, 90 feet or 27 meters high at the peak, and 4 blocks or approximately 1,375 feet or 490 meters in length. The LED display canopy that encompasses the Viva Vision show runs along the Fremont Street Experience promenade from Main Street to 4th Street. The canopy, comprising 130,000 square feet of display space, is the world's largest video screen. Within the canopy itself are 220 speakers powered by 550,000 watts of amplification. Light and sound shows run 24/7, but each of the feature shows runs at the top of the hour from 6 p.m. to 1 a.m. every night. The shows run for 6 to 7 minutes. Personally, I can stand under the canopy and watch all these Viva video shows for hours. It is quite magnificent. You must check it out when you go to Las Vegas downtown. A few major downtown hotels such as Plaza, Golden Gate, Circa, Four Queens, and the D are all located very close to the Fremont Street Experience. And don't forget Slotzilla, the zip line over the Fremont Street Experience. Okay, that's all for today. I'll get going. If you have enjoyed it, please do give this video a thumbs up. I really appreciate it. Please subscribe if you want to see more of my weekly videos. I hope to see you again next week. Thanks for watching.